I'm talking about the radical side of the left. I'm talking about Shaun King. Shaun King, a very active Black Lives Matter activist. He's on the left of the Democratic Party. Here's what Shaun King tweeted out during the Democratic primaries. He says, I'll be frank and tell you two Democrats that I'm 99% sure I won't be supporting, primarily because of their dismal history on criminal justice reform over the course of their entire careers, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris. They both helped build and advance mass incarceration. That was during the campaign. Couldn't be clearer, huh? Until Joe Biden gets a nomination, Kamala Harris gets picked as VP. Here is what he says. Without a hint of irony, without any shame, he says, among current U.S. senators, I would rank Kamala Harris in the top three on justice reform issues. He previously said he would 99% not vote for her, specifically because of her dismal history on criminal justice reform for her entire career. Now he says she's in the top three on justice reform issues. That's it for me. I am incredibly proud to see a brilliant Black woman and HBCU grad, historically Black college, chosen as a vice presidential nominee. I've done political work my whole life. It's rarely things dreams are made of. Kamala Harris is the most progressive VP nominee in American history. So at the very top, it's just a clear lie. He says she's one of the worst on criminal justice reform. Now he says she's one of the best on criminal justice reform. But then at the end, look at that. Kamala Harris is the most progressive VP nominee in American history. Now, how can that be the case if he's previously criticizing Joe Biden and Kamala Harris for being among the least progressive in the race? What he said there at the end, she's the most progressive VP nominee in American history, that's true. He's actually, it's not a lie. I mean, he's obviously a shill and he'll shill for the Democrats regardless. That's embarrassing for him. But what he's saying there is true, and it's not because of her. In another universe, she could be somewhat conservative. She doesn't believe anything. She's just an empty vessel. But because of how much the left has advanced progressively since at least Woodrow Wilson for the last 100 years, she is the most progressive nominee because they're all on the same page. They are marching with the tides of history. They will change their opinions and move them to the left simply by virtue of time. Remember, Joe Biden. When Joe Biden ran in 2008, by today's standards, he would have been very conservative. Same thing in 1990, he would have been very, very conservative. Same thing in 1970s, he would have been very, very, very conservative. But he doesn't believe anything. What is moving to the left is not him. He and Kamala don't, they're not people. They're not individuals in the political sense. They just go along with the party. They just go along with the progressive movement. I hope you enjoyed that short segment from The Michael Knowles Show. Be sure to check out the full episode linked in the description or download the podcast wherever you listen to podcasts.